Breaking news on those freedom flights from Haiti. Michelle?
Well, it has been very busy here this afternoon. Three more flights came in. So since Saturday, that makes 22 flights with just about 2,000 evacuees that have come into Sanford. As the evacuees step out of the belly of the giant Air Force cargo planes, each come with their own story.
When you got on that plane, was it a relief?
It was.
Pascal and her 8-year-old daughter told us theirs. They live 30 minutes from Port-au-Prince. When the earthquake hit, Pascal says her daughter Yana knew what was happening before she did.
She knew. She's American, my daughter. And she said, oh, my God, Mom, is it an earthquake? Is it an earthquake? And I was like, yes.
And when it was happening, what was going through your mind?
I'm going to die. I'm going to die.
What did it feel like, honey?
It felt like a giant bomb hit Haiti.
Pascal is an artist, a painter. She lives part-time in Haiti, part-time in the U.S. What's it like in Haiti now?
There was no food, no water, no anything, no electricity, no phone working, nothing.
You said it was like what?
Watching. It was like watching us die without knowing where to go.
When the U.S. Air Force made this trip possible, Pascal knew where to go. She hopped on the C-17. The feeling of relief also came with fear.
A U.S. Air Force plane, it's usually war, you know.
But this is not a war, it is a rescue, and that is the third plane leaving right now. She tells us that her plans are to go to Coral Springs and live with her grandmother. Live in Sanford, Michelle Meredith, West 2 News.